Birdhouse is probably one of my favorite locations to film at.
The Birdhouse has been a central location for us.
All the different plot points kind of end up weaving through here.
It became a character unto itself.
It is kind of another family member, you know?
Stunningly beautiful. I mean, it is beautiful.
The beauty of that location is those windows and that lake.
This house has been amazing for us. It kind of told us what it needed to be. It sort of delivered us a look of Ozark. As much as we sought it out, it kind of found us.
Like a good 90% of my scenes have been here.
Not gonna get emotional. Here we go, wait a minute, here it comes. Not doing it. The first day I was on set, I showed up at this house. My last day I'm here. So,
when anyone says to me Ozark, that's what flashes in my mind, is the Birdhouse.
Honestly, really kind of bizarre. This is like one of the last times I'm actually gonna walk through this place. I've been here since I was like 12 or 13 or something. Let's take a look. These pictures, I think those were on our first day, actually, the whole bird family getting together at the studio to take these pictures. When they're like, you know, you get a little bit closer, a little bit closer. That was when I really realized that it's gonna be a really good group of people to be working with.
I think my first scene here was the scene, the yellow taxi cab scene with Laura.
Mom, what are we doing here? Your father's laundering money for a Mexican drug cartel.
It's like become our home in a way, and now, 5 years later, it's not going to be anymore.
This house has always been constant and been consistent in the story. It signifies their unity and their togetherness as a family.
The Birdhouse definitely has sort of become a character in the show. The way it was initially introduced, it was like literally attached to Buddy.
Who is that?
That is Buddy Diker.
We're all dying the minute we're born. Goes fast. Don't waste it. Don't waste it.
There's been a lot of really pivotal things that have gone down right in this area. A big scene from season one was when Navarro's hitman, Garcia, came in. I came in that door with the gun that I had gotten from Tuck.
Stay back.
But Buddy had taken out the ammo from the gun, and he came in with a shotgun of his own.
You need to shut your tamale hole.
Sort of saved him from having to have that moment. Being here definitely reminds me of Buddy walking down to the lake to go skinny dipping. That's definitely one of the most iconic moments where you just kind of realize the absurdity of everything that's going on. And it's cool how that was paralleled with Ben when he runs down to the lake. The Birdhouse has been sort of tainted by different events that have happened. And eventually the bird parents kind of turn it into more of a prison for the kids.
I need to know where both of you are every second of every day. Do you understand that?
Oh, so like prisoners.
So at the point after he finds out that Ben was ultimately killed because of his mom's decision, and he blasts a hole in the windows. That blowing out of the windows is sort of a representation of wanting to escape that prison.
Why? Why'd you shoot the windows out?
I was upset because Mom killed Ben.
It's not that simple.
Here, of course, is the kitchen. This is where I feel like Jonah ends up grabbing snacks.
Cool.
It kind of stinks in there because this isn't actually on. And here is the messy garage. Oh, and there's a bird in here too. So So this is where Marty had his famous money laundering 101 speech. Jonah is kind of, you can tell he's developing an interest for it.
Could you explain all of it?
Okay.
And that's kind of the precursor to now going into season 4.
I'm not using your software, I wrote my own.
Jesus, laundering at 14.
Do not be proud of him right now.
Over here is my room. It's definitely some mixed feelings coming towards the end of this experience. It's ending, and that's sad for everyone, for the viewers, for us. We've, you know, come to have so many good relationships for cast and crew alike. But on the other hand, we achieved what we wanted to. We're happy with what we have. All right. Definitely gonna miss this view.
It all is ending tomorrow, and it is, it's like saying goodbye, honestly. It's like when a character dies or when somebody picture wraps or something, they're gonna say, you know, that's a wrap on the birdhouse, and I think we're all gonna be pretty emotional over it.